Getting your tactic set up and ready is only part of the equation in Football Manager. We need to do things in the match to help you win those matches. And today, we're going to do just that. Right, crew, so first off, let me introduce you to the skin we'll be using today. It's down below, it's the Tato skin, and that's going to help us make these changes in match using the statistics as they come in. By the way, we'll be using Anderlecht for this, just a game I'm playing around with, trying some new tactics with. We're going to go with them. So let me give you a little walkthrough of the match day screen I like to set up. So from the far side, we've got match stats, and under match stats, I've added in progressive passes and final third passes. This alone will show you how the game's starting off, who's getting the better attacking chances. Below that is match momentum. Again, you're going to have the bars come up as the match goes on, so you can have a good sight of that. This is especially key, by the way, if you're a key highlight player. If you don't watch extended or comprehensive, you don't really have much idea what's going on, but these little tools here will help. On the far side, you've got both formations above my head there. You've got the opposition and yours, so you can see any adaptions. And in the middle is the big monster tab. Now, quite daunting looking, the three I like to use is the home stats, the player stats, the away stats, and the heat map as well. Those three are going to help me make changes in the match to hopefully affect the way things are going. So we're going to play a few minutes of the match now. We'll come back and we'll see what we can adjust. Now, while you're here, remember, drop a sub, because this channel is growing. That's what we're trying to do, keep it growing. So the more likes and subscriptions we get, the bigger we get, the more content gets pumped out. Now, as I come back, you can see that Eupen have taken the lead. So 31 minutes gone. Why is that? If we have a quick look at the match stats, we can see final third passes and progressive passes, kind of level. We've been a little bit on top, so maybe they've caught us on the break. The goal was a set piece. Possession, ball share, pretty level. Match momentum up and down. It's a 50-50 match. So we need to change something because we're not dominating like we probably should be. Next thing we'll look at is the formations. Eupen are playing a back three. We're playing wide, so potentially we could go wider. So maybe we need to take advantage of the fact that we're going to have an overload on both sides. So if we've got a play instructions, you can see at the minute we're fairly wide, passing into space. Maybe we'll just drop that up a bit so the play gets spread a little bit more, and we'll calm the tempo down because it looks like we might be wasting a few passes. We've only got 80% of the passes completed. We'll drop that down to higher so they can be a bit more selective. The next thing we'll look at is the match stats. We can see we've had 6 shots, none on target. Maybe we're not choosing the right shot. We're taking too many shots at bad times. So I've just looked down the shooting channel down here and can see Francis Amuzu's taken 2 shots, 0%. Same with Arnstad, 2 shots, 0%. They're not on target, so we can solve that pretty easily. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop him from attacking duty to support, because that means he'll have a bit more emphasis on picking out a pass rather than shooting, and add to that, shoot less often. If you look at him as well, it makes more sense when you hover over your player, checking out his long shots and his finishing. It's not great, so we'll try that. As the game goes on, we're still having loads of chances, but Eupen are starting to get into the game as well as we look at the match momentum. So why is that? We'll have a look at their home stats and we can see that Wakaso has had 2 key passes with a 7.2 rating, already has the assist. He's a bit of an issue. Where's he playing? He's the left wing back. He's getting tired though, so that's going to help us. What else can we do though? So he's coming down our right hand side, which is Marulio and Stroikens. Now Stroikens not having a great game up there, on a 6.4, and he's really attacking, so he's not really helping out Marulio. So what we're going to do is we'll take Stroikens off and we're going to change the role as well. We made the change, so we've changed from an inside forward on attack to an inverted winger on support. He will drop deeper to get the ball off Murillo and help out as well. We've also added the player instruction of Mark's specific position, so he's going to keep an eye on that role. And the other thing to realise is that Rackman has work rate of 16, so he's going to work really hard with stamina to help that out. So he should be a good change. He should help to nullify the threat down the left-hand side. Still chasing the game, however, so we're going to add work ball into box. We're having so many chances, 15 shots. So we're taking too many shots. Let's calm them down, get some more on target, and get this goal that we definitely deserve. With time running out, I like to think those changes have helped. Here's for Tongan to Amuzu. Now remember, Amuzu was the man who was playing really well, but taking too many shots. We change him to an inverted winger to up his creativity, and let's have a little look. He lays the ball back, and look where he finds himself. He's got bodies in there. Obviously, he's not going to shoot from there, right? Right? No, he doesn't. He crosses it through, working the ball into the box. Esposito scores. We get that deserved equaliser. There you see it. Look, we dominated the match and all them tweaking and tweaking, we finally got the goal we deserved. An XG of 2.74. So hopefully that shows you little tweaks you can make rather than just sitting back, leaving your team to it. Little tweaks can help. The biggest one for that one was probably the change of roles and duty and the work ball into the box when we're having so many shots. Now, how about defensive instructions? If you think you're going to get a bit of a battering or the game's completely swung. And for this, I've chose a game against the best team in the league, Genk. So we should be under a bit of pressure here. You can see they've won 5 in a row. As we're settling into the match, after 10 minutes, if I have a look at the match stats and the progressive passes and the final third passes, so far, so good. Momentum's ours as well. Now, half time, it's going great. We've took the lead through Esposito. We're dominating possession, passing, chances. It's all going well. But this year in FM23, momentum changes and a top team like Genk, I'm expecting them to come at us. So let's see. We'll give it a few minutes. And we'll see if we need to make any defensive tweaks. So we're 15 minutes off the end now. Genk have just had about 4 or 5 shots in quick succession. They're starting to come back into it. So we need to have a little look. I looked at the match stats. The final third passes have shot up. They've started to crank it up. We haven't changed formation. When I look at the formation, that's the same. We may have gone more attacking. And when I look at the away stats, we can see one of their players is proving a bit of a thorn in our side. And it's Hrusovsky. I think that's how you say it. Let's have a closer look at what he's doing. So hovering over him, let's call him Patrick, I can see immediately that he doesn't take corners and free kicks. His set pieces aren't good enough. So that means that his 4 key passes are legit. So he's making them from open play. And if I look at the formation, I can see he's playing in that pivot role there. So it's all coming through him from there. So the first thing I want to do is I want to tight mark him. So when he gets the ball, someone's really close to him. Next, I'm going to look at my team. He's playing on the left-hand side of their centre mid. So in this position here, directly opposite Diawara. We've got the lead. We're 1-0 up. And Volante can break quite forward quite often. So I'm going to change his role. He's now a defensive midfielder. So he's not going to go too far. And he's going to keep a closer eye on that guy. Also, to be super cautious, because he's dominating the match, let's get him on him. Let's get him on him. So we've got two choices here, position or role. Because the player is the one dominating this match, we're going to make him mark him man for man. Get right up in his face. So we've got Diawara on a defensive role now, not that secondary role. You can see he's deep there. He's got Savovsky very close to him. When we play this on, Diawara is so deep now, picking the ball up deeper and sticking there. Look at him sticking there. He's starting to go forward now because we've got a chance and he's on support as he goes forward. But he's quickly to hold back. Strikers has got the ball. He thinks about going forward, but then he goes back. If he was on secondary role, he would be going forward. It just gives us that more insurance and means he can keep a closer eye on this guy too. With about 15 seconds to go, we've handled it brilliantly. We're 2-0 up now, score on the break. And if we look at Patrick Swovsky, he hasn't added to his key passes at all. Diawara has clinched him. He's locked him down. Their creative outlet is gone. And we've seen this game out. A really solid 2-0 win against one of the best teams, if not the best team in the league, keeping their XG low, only conceding 2 shots on target. Great stuff. So we've covered some attacking tweaks and some defensive tweaks against Genk there. We've still got Ghent and Bruges, the best team to come, but using that sort of stuff, I back ourselves now. We're top of the league. We can go on and win this. So just some tools to use in match. It just shows you, if you holiday through matches, you're not going to get the chance to do that. So if you're wondering why your tactic's not working, your tactic might be solid. You just may need to tweak a little few things during the match to get the win. Meanwhile, check this video out from Llama. It blew my mind and it led to a 3-game winning streak for me. Highly recommend it.